Welcome to ePathsala lecture series. We are discussing about the paper cryptography and network security. In this paper, we are going to discuss about the module number theory. So, number theory, where it is playing a vital role in cryptographic algorithms. In the introductory classes and previous lecture series, where we have discussed about various background of cryptography, where basically this deals with the number theory. So, in this session, we are going to introduce about the number theory along with the importance of some of the examples related with the number theory. So, importance of number theory, the encryption algorithm depends heavily on the modular arithmetic. So, for example, if you have taken a CISA cipher or a FIN cipher, where we discuss under the classical cryptography, basically it is using a modular arithmetic, modular operation. So, what is the importance of modular arithmetic? How we are going to use this modular arithmetic in that particular algorithm? How it is going to perform an encryption as well as decryption with the help of your modular arithmetic? That is what the thing related with that. So, we need to develop various machineries for manipulating number before can be describing algorithm in the natural fashion. So, where we have encryption, we use mod 26 in the case of your CISA cipher, and also we use in the affine cipher, where we are taking the relatively prime number and also we perform the mod 26. So, where basically we can understand what is the importance of a number theory in the place of your classical cryptography as well as in the case of your modern cryptographic algorithm. So, this is going to be the base step towards the number theory concepts, which is going to be happening over a modern algorithm, such as where we can have something like our DES algorithm, AES algorithm, all this algorithm, where we have the concepts behind with the help of your modular operations. So, here we are going to start with a number theory. So, number theory, we want to know about what is number theory. And also, we are going to discuss about the binary operation related with the number theory. Mainly, before going to know about the number theory, we need to know what is the division and also integers, how it is going to be related with the, and we are going to discuss about the divisibility and GCD of a given number, and some way of doing this with the help of some known popular algorithm called Euclidean algorithm. And also, finally, we are going to discuss about the extended Euclidean algorithm. The keywords related with this particular concept is integers, binary operation, Euclidean, this is going to be discussed. So, before beginning with your divisibility or division of your particular algorithm, we need to know what is an integer. Set of integers. The set of integer is denoted by the letter Z, contains all the integral number with no fraction from negative infinite to the positive infinite. So, we can able to represent where z is equal to, where you can able to see all the numbers 0, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, minus 2, like that up to infinite. So, it consists of a set of integers denoted by z, where most commonly in all over the algorithms we are going to discuss about this particular z, where we are going to discuss in the case of your number theory. So, it contains all the integral numbers with no fractions. So, it starts from negative infinite to positive infinite. Then, what is a binary operation? So, binary, we know what is binary. Binary means where you can take two input and creates one output. So, any particular operation, whenever it is going to be considered in the case of your mathematical process, where taking two inputs and provides one output, we say that is called binary operations. So, in cryptography, we are interested in three binary operations applied to a set of integers. So, binary operation means an operation that takes two input and creates one output. So, what is that binary operation we are going to discuss? Let us say z is going to be your set of integer. As already mentioned, it has all the integral numbers starting from positive infinite, starting from 0 to positive infinite as well as to the negative infinite. So, where you can able to see the majorly we have three binary operations, one is plus, minus, multiplication, that is addition, subtraction and multiplication. So, these operation again it is going to give that. So, it takes 2 a and b from the set of integer, again it is going to give the resulting of the result C again it is going to be a set of an integer. So, overall we can able to see that any binary operation it takes the two value from the set, again it is going to be a part of your set. So, the next operation we have a integer division. So, integer division in integer arithmetic, if we divide A by B, A by N, we will get Q. So, into the integer arithmetic, normally we will do in the case of your school days, where we come out of an dividing of a number, if we divide A by N, we will get Q. And there is one special thing what is related with your cryptography is R, most commonly we are going to work on that particular R, which is nothing but your remainder. So, the relationship between these four integers can be shown as A is equal to Q into N plus R. So, Q is your, where you can say that Q is an integer, N is an integer, R is an integer. So, everything is going to be a set of integer. So, in this case we are taking one example, A is equal to 255, N is equal to 11. So, what is the quotient and the remainder? So, A is a dividend or N is the divisor, where you get a two other integers, we call that is a quotient and the remainder. So, Q is a quotient, another R is a remainder. So, using the division algorithm, normally you do step by step, right. So, we will take the 11, 255, meanwhile we will get. So, what is that thing, very interesting part of this particular algorithm is, so we should know how an A is going to be relating with your N, Q and R, that is what we need to understand. So, as A is equal to Q into N plus R. So, which is going to be a first step towards the number theory. If you are able to understand how it is going to be related, then automatically we can able to support with that number theory. So, integer division where we have a again a set of integer, where we can say always we will say that A is equal to Q into N plus R. Again it is Q is going to be your set of integer, N is going to be a positive, R is a non-negative, which is a remainder, which is going to be used most of the cryptographic algorithm. Divisibility, if A is not a 0 and we let R is equal to 0 in the division relation. So, divisibility we know. So, what is the condition? We check that A is not 0 and let R is equal to 0 in the division relation, we will get A is equal to Q into N. If the remainder is 0, so A divided by N, if the remainder is not 0, then that means a divisible. We say that here it is pipe symbol, it is not a slash. It is saying that where A is when remainder is equal to 0, then this number is divisible by A. If that is not equal to 0, then it is not going to be. So, the not divisible is going to be represented by A into A not N that way. So, what are the properties related with divisibility, right? So, property where it is going to explain about. So, how I am going to take this input, how I am going to proceed that particular output based on what kind of operations are going to be done, right. In this case, the divisibility, if I am taking two numbers, I want to check for their property. Okay. So, in this case, there are four properties are going to be explained. The first property, if A is going to be divisible by 1, then A is equal to plus or minus 1. If A is divisible by B and B is divisible by A, then A is equal to plus or minus B. The third property, if A is divisible by B and B is divisible by C, then A is A divisible by C. So, the fourth property, if A divisible by B and A divisible by C, then we can write A is equal to M into B plus N into C, where M and N are the arbitrary integers. So, whenever I take any number, okay, any number, I have to check if it is going to be having a such a property. Suppose I take a suppose a property in 1, property 2, property 3, property 4, I will check whether this number is going to be having such a property. Then I can able to say that that number is going to be divisible of that another number. So, let divisors, let A and B, A, B and C be the integers such that A is equal to B into C. So, what is the case here? So, we say that A is equal to B into C. So, we can say that B and C are divide or factors. We say that is going to be a factor of the A, while A is said to be the multiple of B, or you can able to say that it is a multiple of C. So, that way you can able to say A is said to be a multiple of B, or A is said to be multiple of C, in such a way that we can able to get that particular. So, here the symbol, pipe symbol denotes a device. so that the situation summarize B device A, okay, intersect C device A in such way that where you are able to get the divisors. So, we can say that A and B and C are going to be your divisors. So, we will take some of the example, okay, related with that particular definition where we did. So, which of the following are true, right? Let us take, there are 5 questions are asked, right? So, for example, 1, 77 divides 7, 7 divides 77, 24 divides 24, 0 divides 24, 24 divides 0. So, among this, which is going to be true, which are going to be the false question? As what our definition, we say that B divides A, okay, as what it is. Again, you can able to know that here, it is saying that it is a, what is that? It is a pipe symbol. So, pipe symbol says that it is a divisor. So, 77 divides 7, which is true, is it possible? No, 77 cannot divide 7. And what is the property? We want to check with the property, right. So, as a way here, we can able to check with the property in such a way that A divides 1, then we can say that A is equal to plus or minus 1. So, as you take the divisor of a particular number, A, B and C be the integer such that A must be a multiple of B as well as C, right. Then only you can say that A is equal to B dot C, right. So, then can become these two are factors, right. So, A is equal to B, C are going to call as a factors. So, now check with that particular answer. For example, I am taking the following cases. So, what is the answer we are getting? 77 divides 7, false, because bigger number can't divide the smaller positive integer. 77 divides 77, true, because we can able to get that factor of 7 and 11, where B dot C, right. So, if we say that 77 is multiple of B as well as 77 is multiple of C. 24 divided by 4, 24 is true, because 24 is going to be equal to 24 dot 1, like that. 0 divides 24, false, only 0 is divisible by 0. 24 divides 0, true, because 0 is divided by every number, what you get is again a 0. So, 0 as what we can say, we say usually we use a notation, right. So, slash to say that divisibility, but this case where you can able to see that whenever you have a this divisors, we want to check with that whether it is going to be all or not. So, some of the examples of divisors where you can take the divisor of 140, divisor of 12. So, when you take all these numbers related with 140, 7, 14, 5, 140, 70, all these numbers are divisor of 40, that means it is the multiple or a factors of 140. Similarly, if you take 12, we have 1, 2, 4, 6, 3, 12, all these are going to be a factor. So, what is our ultimate goal? We want to find the common divisor. Suppose I am taking 140 and 12, I want to find out the common divisor among these two numbers. What is the common divisor? We take where it is intersecting. So, as per the property, where you can say that B divides A intersects C divides A, where you can say that if it is going to be having a commonality, right. So, where you can say that 1, 2, 4, all these 3 numbers are going to be dividing 140 and 12, we say that is going to be a common divisor of 140 and 12. So, what are the facts related with your division is, first fact, the integer 1 has only one divisor and itself. And second fact is, any positive integer has at least 2 divisors, 1 and itself. So, we can able to see that. So, here if it is going to related with your, for example, if I take a prime number, right. So, prime number, then I can say that integer 1 has only one divisor and itself, it cannot be a prime number. If I take a positive integer has at least 2 divisor, 1 and itself, but it can have more, then it is not a prime number. If it is going to be having 1 and itself, we can say that is good. So, this fact is applicable for your divisor of a particular number. If I take any number, suppose I am taking a 25, I can able to see that. So, fact 2 is going to be applicable. 25 have any positive integer has at least 2 divisor, 1 and 25, apart from that we can have a 5. So, like that we can able to say that based on this fact, I can able to say that whether a number has a divisor and it is going to be based on the property of your divisibility. Then we can able to identify whether this number is going to be suitable for providing with our number theory. So, the next concept what you are going to discuss related with your number theory is going to be your GCD, that is your greatest common divisor. So, most of the cases, for example, if I take a affine cipher, we come out with the relatively prime numbers, right. So, relatively prime number is nothing but two number whose GCD is going to be 1, then we can say these two are going to be a relatively prime number. So, most of the cryptographic algorithm, we want to find out if a number is given whether it is going to be relatively prime number or not. So, how we can able to do that with the basis of your this concept related with your number theory. So, GCD, if I know the GCD of a given number, then I can able to find out if the two numbers are given, if the GCD is going to be 1, then I can able to say that it is going to be a relatively prime number. Then I can use that number for my any particular algorithm. Now, we will start with a general GCD of a given number. So, GCD is a greatest common divisor. As earlier example where we have discussed related with this, suppose I take a common divisors. What are the common divisors of 140 and 12 is 1, 2 and 4. So, why 1 can divide 4, 40, 2 also, 12 also can be divisible by 1, 12 also divisible by 2, 140 also divisible 2, 4, 140 also divisible 4, 12 also divisible 4. Whereas, if you take 6, it cannot divide 140, if I take 20, it cannot divide the 12. So, that is going to be a common, this is what we understand from the GCD. GCD, the greatest common divisor of two positive integer is the largest integer that can divide both the integers. So, I want to find the common, right. So, I want to find the common between the two numbers. When I know the common divisor, among that common divisor, what is the greatest common divisor of the two positive integer in the largest integer that can be dividing both the integers, then we can say. So, what is the factor related to the GCD? So, GCD of a comma 0 is going to be a, because we can say that when you say the GCD of a comma 0, then we can take a as the greatest common divisor which can divide a, and GCD of a comma b is equal to GCD of b comma r, where r is the remainder of the dividing a by b. So, based on this only we can able to find out the GCD of two given numbers. So, let us take this particular diagram which is going to be explaining about how we are going to find the algorithm related to your GCD. Suppose you are given with a GCD of a comma b is equal to 1, we say that a and b are prime, relatively prime, already I told you. So, we want to say that when the two positive integers are given, if I am finding a GCD of two positive integer, when I am getting 1, then we can say that two numbers are going to be a relatively prime numbers. So, that the case here, we say look at the algorithm. So, we are going to take two numbers, either you can take as what a or b, which is from the same set of integers, from the set of integers as I have defined in the beginning of this particular lecture, where we have z, which has both the positive and a negative integers, which can be infinitely, it is going to be there, positive and negative integer with a infinite series, which is going to be there. Based on that number, I will take that, while if I take r 2, which is going to be greater than 0, only the condition here is, based on the fact, if I take, what is this? This is your b. So, what is the condition here? Where you are checking whether b is greater than 0. If it is 0, what you will do? We simply say a is a GCD of a comma b. Suppose b is 0, if we assume that, in this case, if b is 0, I can say that GCD of a comma b is going to be a only. But now, as per our algorithm, what says here is, while r 2 is greater than 0, r 2 is greater than 0, then I will proceed with this particular step. So, what I am doing? I am doing a division, right. So, r 2, r 1 divided by r 2, right, r 1 divided by r 2, and I am just assigning to a q. So, what is that value I will get? Generally, r 1 divided by r 2, where I am going to get the quotient. So, I am putting in the q, that is your quotient, then r is going to be assigned by r 1 minus q into r 2. So, I am going to get the remainder, and I am swapping. So, each and every time I am doing, how long I am going to proceed here is, until I am going to get this out of this particular while loop, right. So, when I this while loop become, that is our r 1, each and every time we are doing for this r 2, we are checking for r 2, when r 2 is less than 0 or equal to 0, then automatically it come out of this particular while loop. So this is the condition. While R2 is greater than 0, each and every time I am going to perform with this particular iteration. So how long I am going to proceed until R2 becomes 0. When R2 becomes 0, then automatically it comes of that particular 0. So GCD of A comma B, where you are going to assign, so which is nothing but your R1, that is what the value we are going to get finally. The process is explained in the left hand side of your diagram, where this is an algorithm. Again, you can able to take that as in the step wise, we can able to understand R1 is equal to A, R2 is equal to B, where these are the two integers which is given. So we will take each and every time we will take the remainder, and we are assigning to the, so we can able to see that the quotient R1 is going to be assigning to the, sorry, quotient B, okay. So B is going to be assigned to the R1, and R2, each and every time you are going to assign the R2 remainder to R2, that is what we are doing, right? R2, right. So that is going to be assigned to that. So each and every time you can take R and you are assigning to R2, R assigning to R2, each and every step until your remainder becomes 0, R less than 0. So once you get 0, what you are doing? So when your remainder becomes 0, we say that it is R1 is going to be your final greatest common divisor. So this is what the process involved in this particular algorithm. So this algorithm, where it is going to give you the output as what is the common divisor, greatest common divisor of this A and B. So we have A and B is given. When you are going to proceed with this algorithm, what you are going to get finally as your greatest common divisor. Relatively, as already mentioned you, which is very important, and also we are most commonly using that. So A comma B is equal to 1, GCD of A comma B is 1. So we say that A and B are relatively prime numbers. So let us take one example for finding the greatest common divisor of 2740 and 1760. So what is the GCD of this number? So if I am going to take a normal way of doing this operation, right? So how we are going to do in the school days, right? So each and every time I want to divide this number as what in the previous algorithm where we did. So we will be dividing and taking the quotient, and you are doing each and every step, it will be more time consuming, right? So in that case, so anyway you have this answer, as per this step we will proceed. So where we have an algorithm or a method is given which can easily get this particular answer, right? So that is what here it is mentioned in the case of your this algorithm. So if I am going to for a normal way of proceeding, what I will do, I want to find the factor of this number, I want to find the factor of this number. So factorization may be very very difficult for a larger number. If it is going to be a smaller number, easily we can able to factorize, but if it is going to be a larger number, it will be very difficult for factoring, and also after factoring we have to find out which are the common factors among these two numbers, and after that we will go for multiplying the two number and get the common divisor. Instead of that, we will follow this algorithm. For example, the steps are explained in this particular algorithm. As we take this, we are taking the example of finding the GCD of 2740 and 1760. We are getting answer as 20. How we are getting the answer as 20, right? GCD of 2740 and 1760 is equal to 20. We do normal process as I mentioned, we will do with a paper and pen, right? But in the case of your algorithm, which makes very simple, where you do this process as what it is mentioned in this particular steps. The steps of this algorithm is going to be mentioned here. So where you can take Q, R1, R2 and R. So as what 2740 is R1, 1760 is R2. So when I am dividing, right? So what is the first step we mentioned? R1 divided by R2, which says that Q. So R1 divided by R2, one time it goes, we say 1, the remainder is going to be 980, right? Next step again, R1 divided by R2. So before that, we have to shift this, right? So I was swapping the R2 and R. So what you are saying, R2 is going to be now changed to 980. 980 again, R2 is changed to R1, 1760. 1760 divided by 980, again it goes for one time, we will get 780. Again, we are doing the same process each and every time until we will get the 0. For example, the remainder is going to be 0. So as we proceed for the next step, so this will come to 780, this 200 will come to R2. Now again we are dividing, 3 times it goes, 180 is the remainder. So 200 will come here, 180 will come here. Now one time it will get, so 200, 180 will get the remainder as 20, and now we are getting into the final step where you say 180 divided by 20 will get remainder as 0. At this point we will stop, we come out with the answer as 20. So we can able to see that how fast this computation is going to be happening, right? So all this because of this algorithm. So without this algorithm, if we proceed, it will take a more time when you are going to compute for the GCD of two given numbers. So very, very simple algorithm where it is going to be given for computing this particular algorithm. So that the name of this algorithm is Euclidean's algorithm. So Euclidean algorithm for finding the GCD of given number. The name of this algorithm is Euclidean's. So Euclidean algorithm where we want to go for proceeding with identifying A and B, and based on the we will assign the assignment. So with the help of this Euclidean algorithm, it makes very simpler and also easy way of finding the GCD of two given numbers. Next, what we are going to discuss about is extended Euclidean algorithm. So what is this Euclidean algorithm says? So Euclidean algorithm where we take two integer and we'll check whether integer is going to be 0. If integer is going to be a 0, we say that greatest common divisor. For example, a comma 0 is equal to, we can say directly it says that a is equal to 0. That's the first step. If b is not equal to 0, if it's going to be greater than 0, then we'll be keep on doing a dividing that particular number, right? So that is why we are studying about a divisibility. Why I started with the divisibility, because of the reason is, so whenever you are going to talk about any of the cryptographic algorithm, maximum we use the GCD of the two given numbers. In that case, we need to understand the divisibility. So without understanding the divisibility, it is very difficult for understanding about the concept of GCD of a given number. So once I am going to find the GCD of a given number, I can easily find which is going to be the relatively prime number. So when I am able to find out the relatively prime number, then I can use that particular number for the encryption process. So actually this is becomes a very important as well as the background process related with your number theory. So definitely any person, if they want to be understanding of any encryption or decryption algorithm, definitely they know about the finding of this divisibility as well as the GCD of the given number. So now we are entering into the extended Euclidean algorithm. In this extended Euclidean algorithm, it is extending the previous algorithm. What the way it is going to be extending? So it is giving two integer a and b. We often need to find the other two integer s and t. So what is the idea behind this algorithm is, which can help you to find out the multiplicative inverse, another important component of your cryptographic algorithm. What we can say is a multiplicative inverse. So here, what is the, why it's called extended? Because this is going to have some additional integers apart from your a and b. We also find other two integers s and t such that. So what is the advantage of here? At the same time, calculates the value of s and t. How we are did in the previous thing, it is also doing the process related with your. Additionally, it is going to be using the two other integers, that is your s and t. Maximum we use this in the case of your multiplicative inverse. When you are finding the multiplicative inverse of any number, we will get the particular Euclidean algorithm. So we will discuss this related with your multiplicative inverse whenever you are discussing about the multiplicative inverse, and that case we will discuss about the extended Euclidean algorithm, and also we will work out about the. So what are the concepts related with the particular series is, we discussed about the outlined the concept of number theory, what is the importance of number theory in the field of cryptography, how it is working in the case of your encryption and decryption algorithm, and also we have discussed about the integer division, how it is important in the case of finding the GCD of the given number, and also some of the property. Whenever considering a divisibility, definitely you have to understand the property of related with the divisibility. Then we have discussed about the GCD with the various examples, and also we have discussed about the GCD using a Euclidean algorithm, which makes very simpler and also make the easier way to compute the large integers when it is going to be given to find the GCD of the given number. So with this, we are coming to the end of this particular session. Thank you.